All of us have been given this purpose as to why we were created and why we were placed on this planet Earth. One of the basic ingredients that will help us drive this whole purpose for life is what I call passion. Today, I want to speak to you on how to use my God-given passion. All of us have got passion. We all want to achieve what God has entrusted upon us as long as we are on this earth. And I want to speak to you five parts from the life of Moses. And I want to talk to us about how that we can learn from the success and the failures of Moses' life. You see, one of the reasons why God has placed characters in the Bible, I believe with all of my heart, is so that we can learn from their failures and their successes. Today we will learn about what Moses went through and what were the failures he had and what were the successes he's had, so that we can implement it in our own lives as we try to discover this very passion for our own purpose for living. Before we talked about any principles that we can derive from Moses' life, I want to first of all talk a little bit about his background. Now, Moses was born in a time when the affliction was harsh upon the Israelites in Egypt. Let me just remind you that after the death of Joseph, a great affliction had come upon the nation of Israel that lived in that particular country of Egypt. And the affliction was so great that there was an order from the king that all the male child should be slain. But thankfully, the mother of Moses kept Moses alive by floating him on a basket, placed that basket, which was well designed, on a reeds, among the reeds on the riverside. And as the story goes, the daughter of Pharaoh, who had come to bathe in that river, had seen this basket and was asked to bring this basket to her. And to her utter shock, she found a little cute baby on this basket. And as the order was very strict that every male child must be killed, there was a plan that had crept up in the mind of the daughter of Pharaoh. And one of her servants had discovered that there was a midwife who was willing to take this child and to take care of this child. And this midwife happens to be the mother of Moses himself. And the interesting thing is this, that the mother of Moses had the privilege to raise her own child by being paid to do so. And this is the interesting part about Moses' life. Moses was raised by his own mother and was told about the history of the Israelites right from the time when he began to understand most of the things. And the mother of Moses raised him until a particular time where the daughter of Pharaoh took him and counted him, adopted him as her own son. And Moses grew up in Egypt as a son of the daughter of Pharaoh. He dressed like an Egyptian. He walks like an Egyptian. He must have talked like an Egyptian. But in his heart of hearts, he's an Israelite. In his mind, he's an Israelite. His heart is for the Israelites. While he dressed like an Egyptian, his mind and his heart were towards his own people. He was told by his mother that he is not an Egyptian. He is an Israelite by birth, and he shall be an Israelite. And so, as we look at the story of Moses, we realize that there are many things we can learn from. Today we're talking about passion. There is one particular incident that had taken place in the life of Moses where we can learn from today as we reflect upon how to use this God-given passion for our lives. You see, Moses also had passion. He had zeal. His passion was so great for several reasons. Now, if you look at Exodus chapter 2, verse 11 to 15, in there we see that Moses had appeared on the scene after he was introduced to be as the son of the daughter of Pharaoh. In there we read like this: "Now when Moses had become a man, one day he went out to his people and saw how hard their work was. And he saw an Egyptian giving blows to a Hebrew, one of his people. And turning this way and that, and seeing no one, he put the Egyptian to death, covering his body with sand. And he went out that day after he saw two of the Hebrews fighting. And he said to him, 'Who was wrong? Why are you fighting, you brothers?' And he said, 'Who made you a ruler and a judge over us? Are you going to put me to death as you did with the Egyptian?' And Moses was in fear and said, 'It is clear that the thing has come to light.' Now when Pharaoh had news of this, he would have put Moses to death. But Moses went in flight from Pharaoh into the land of Midian, and he took his seed by a water spring." I want us to reflect about Moses' particular act in this particular incident as we see it. Now Moses, being a daughter of Pharaoh, dressed like an Egyptian, walked around and saw something that was injustice happening before his eyes. And the injustice was an Egyptian had blew an Israelite and had harmed him, had hurt him. And as I said, Moses knew very well that he was not an Egyptian. He is very much an Israelite. And for that very reason, he couldn't stop but to go and protect his own brother. But the silly mistake he did was he killed the Egyptian and buried him under the sand. And the next day, approach and he saw a similar kind of a situation where he saw two Hebrews or two Israelites were fighting amongst each other. And as you know, Moses had gone and tried to interrupt the whole incident. One of them asked, "Who has made you a judge over us?" And the question arose as to would he do the same thing he did yesterday with the Egyptian, killing and burying him underground. You see, Moses had so much zeal. He had so much passion. And his zeal and passion were so great that he was ready to defend his own brother. But I'll tell you this, that the zeal that Moses had was demonstrated at the wrong timing. With great zeal, great passion, demonstrated wrongly in a wrong timing. Secondly, Moses had this great zeal, but his motives were wrong. His motives were wrong. He went to the extent of killing this Egyptian and tried to hide his act by burying this man under the sand. Now think about this. Great passion, great zeal, wrong timing, wrong motive. Now when you have great passion, great zeal, when you demonstrate it in the wrong time, having the wrong motive, What else do you expect? Moses was running for his life. After he was asked this question, as to who made you a judge over us? Are you going to do the same thing which you did yesterday with the Egyptian? Moses was afraid. And he was now trying to escape, because he knew that Pharaoh was going to come after him. After having killed one of his kind, now Moses was running for his life. As we see, he had the same zeal the next day, saw the similar incident, but he got a very different response. The response was, "Who made you a judge over us?" Now Moses ran to Midian, and in there he was sitting by the well. You see, you can have passion, but if my passion are not demonstrated timely, everything can go wrong. If my passion being the fuel for my purpose for living is not implemented, demonstrated on a time that God wants me to demonstrate, having the right kind of motive, everything can go wrong. I want us to look at what we can learn from this very incident that we just saw. The first thing, you can have a great zeal, you can have a great passion, but to demonstrate it wrongly is doomed for disappointment. We can have wrong motives towards fulfilling this purpose for living, using our passion. But if our motives are wrong, we can be disappointed at the end. Secondly, we can have this great passion, this great zeal, and it is all right to have. But to not know God's timing as to when I should demonstrate it is doomed for failure. We will definitely fall if we are not wise enough as to when I should demonstrate this passion. As I said earlier, we all have passions. We all have passions. One wise man said something like this: if you have discovered your passion for living, you will not need to go to work for the rest of your life. Now, what does he mean? He was trying to say that there are plenty of people who still complain about going to work on a daily basis. You see, these people have not discovered their passion. They've not discovered their purpose for living. And there are these passionless people everywhere. Now the question is, what must I do? If we have not discovered this passion, which is a fuel for our purpose for living, then there are a few things we can learn from Moses. The first thing, like Moses, we need to know our roots. Only you know yourself. Only I know myself. You see, we can decide on almost everything in life, but there's only one right that God has reserved it for himself. And that is the decision as to where you and I should be born, in which particular place, in which particular family. This is one thing we cannot do anything about. We can't plead God as to why, God, don't you allow me to be born in that place, in that country? Why not in this particular family? We can't argue with God. That is one decision that God has kept it for himself, and the rest of the decisions are our choices. We can go about making those choices for everything in life. You see, we can't complain to God as to why we were born in this country, why we were born in that country, why we were born in this family, why not in this family. You see, there must be a reason and a purpose as to why God has placed us in a particular country, in a particular family. Moses knew his roots. Even though he was raised up as an Egyptian, taught the ways of an Egyptian, yet he knew his roots. His roots were that of an Israelite. His roots were that of the Jewish people. His mother has taught him. His mother has imprinted in his heart the history of the Israelites and the greatness of this God that they worship and so on. And so Moses knew his roots. Secondly, like Moses, we must develop a passion. We must develop a zeal. You see, Moses developed a passion to lead the people. And we will see that later on in a second part of the that we can learn about Moses' life. Moses had developed this passion on the basis of his knowledge about his roots. And so when he saw that there was an injustice happening, where this Egyptian had come and harmed an Israelite, he can't help himself but to go and defend him and even go to the extent of killing this Egyptian. So he developed this passion because he knew who he really was. And so you and I have got to develop this passion on the basis of why we were born here. Why we were born to this particular family. You see, there are lots and plenty of stories where we hear about particular people who have discovered their passion on the basis of their childhood experience, on the basis of their past life experience. Some of them have experienced poverty in their life. And when they grew up, they wanted to do something for the poor people. And they started organizations to help the poor people. Now, where did that come from? It came from their past experience. You see, God has allowed such people to be born in such condition so that they would understand people who are going through such situations. And so develop a passion on the basis of your experience. Thirdly, Moses was consumed by the zeal. Moses was totally consumed day in and day out by the zeal that he wanted to liberate and free the Israelites from the afflictions of the Egyptians. This is what he sees every day. He goes out, walks around the streets, and sees injustices happening everywhere. Israelites were being afflicted, they were being manipulated, they were being enslaved by the Egyptians. And he can't just watch, but take some action. His zeal was so much that he went to the extreme by killing the Egyptian. Fourth, be prepared and be consistent in your prayer. You see, to be prepared is to be continuing and developing our skills. You see, passion will require us to develop skills that will help us to achieve that great purpose that God has for our lives. And so here what we see is that Moses prepared himself. He was working. He was allowing his skills to develop. His skills of leadership, his skills of negotiating, his skills of trying to intermediate between people that were having problems. He was developing that skill as he practiced it. And so he was preparing himself to want to lead the people out of this slavery, out of this great affliction that had come upon them through the Egyptians. Your passion and my passion has to be developed. Your passion, my passion had to be prepared. We had to be consistent in our preparation, and that too with our prayers. And fifthly, we've got to be looking for opportunities and respond accordingly. You see, Moses saw the great opportunity that had come his way to do something for his people. This was a great opportunity for him, but the motive was wrong. The motive was very wrong. We need to be looking out for opportunities. We need to be looking out for avenues to demonstrate this passion that we have. But we need to have the right kind of motive. Not like Moses. Unlike Moses, who went ahead, demonstrated his passion, his zeal, to want to protect another fellow Israelite, but having the wrong kind of motives, had only led him to disappointment and great failure. And at the end, I would like to say this, that if we continually, consistently develop our passion, because this passion is the primary ingredient that will help us carry out this purpose for life. If we continually develop this, God will honor our persistence. God will honor our persistence. We all have passion. And if you don't have a passion today, I want you to begin to discover this passion. Because you have a purpose. I have a purpose. We all have been given a purpose as to why we are existing on this earth. And passion is the only fuel that will help us, carry out this God-given purpose for our lives. So if you have not discovered your passion today, ask God and say, God, what is my passion? I want to be consumed by my passion. I want to be led by this passion. This passion that is godly, this passion that comes from you. I want to carry out my purpose on the basis of this passion that you have given to me. And so I pray today that as you listen to this word that comes from God, that you will ask God to help you discover your passion that will become like a fuel for you to achieve the purpose for your life. I pray that God will help us to discover this passion. May God bless you. May God bless you. Amen.